Hey guys, what's up? So, I wanted to come in really, really quickly. I wasn't gonna put up a video, but I said I wasn't gonna do videos unless I've been moved or led to do so. And today, I just been moved and led to do so. What's up? How's everybody doing? I wanna talk about getting bothered by things. Today I was hanging out with a friend of mine, and they were talking about this video that they saw on YouTube. And I'm not going to talk about who the video was, what the video, because I don't want to give energy to it. I don't want this person to get any more views than they already have. So I'm not gonna put a link to the video. I'm just gonna say, at the end of the video, I finished watching the video, and it was a person just giving their opinion. And that's what YouTube is. It is broadcast yourself, broadcast your ignorance, broadcast your stupidity, broadcast your hatred, masked in Christianity. Broadcast your bigotry, broadcast your racism, broadcast your love, broadcast your peace, broadcast your integrity. It's broadcast yourself. That's what it is. It's about broadcasting yourself, no matter what it is. Broadcast yourself. So, having said that, this person made a video and was given their opinion about a person, which led to a group of people. And at the end of watching the video, I looked at my friend and I said, "So, what do you want me to do?" And he looks at me and says, "Well, don't you feel some kind of way?" And I was like, "No, I don't." I go, "That person doesn't know me. That person isn't talking to me. This video is not about me. This video is his opinion on something. And I don't know this person. I know the truth about me. I know, and I'm sure the person they're referring to knows the truth about themselves. Don't let someone else's ignorance, sorry guys, don't let someone else's ignorance, someone else's stupidity affect you. Don't let it get to you. Don't let it bother you. Don't let it cause you to question who you are. And don't let it cause you to go to war over something trivial. Something from someone who puts up something just to get a reaction. Sometimes we spend far too much time giving people pieces of our minds that we cannot afford to give away. Sometimes we get so preoccupied with responding to things and rebutting things and saying things to people. And at the end of the day, no matter what we say or how we explain it, how nice we are, how peaceful we are, how much integrity we come at the person with, it is not going to change how they look, feel, or whatever about you, a certain situation, or whatever. Sometimes it's best to just smile and walk away, because getting involved only aggravates you, only causes you hurt, harm, depression, whatever. Sometimes it's best to just skip past the kaflama, confusion and drama, and just move on to something else. Don't let someone else's ignorance, someone else's stupidity affect you. Know who you are, know the truth about you, and move forward. I'm gonna move this because I cannot do that any longer. It's killing my hand. We're gonna try to do it right here. There, perfect. So that's what I want to say. The other thing that I wanted to comment on is this person is someone who is very creative, someone who just has a huge amount of creative energy within them, but they always put it off and put it off and put it off and put it off and put it off. Oh, I'm going to do this when my ship comes in. Oh, I'm going to do this when I get a raise. Oh, I'm going to do this when I get a better job. Oh, I got to wait for a couple of paychecks. Believe me when I say, just recently I did my Enough show in July. I talked about it in the last video briefly. There were 27 artists. It was in a professional gallery. Totally changed from the Enough show that I did with friends. This show I did completely by myself. I produced it. I curated it. And at the very beginning, so many people said they would help. So many people said they would work with me to make the show a success. And in the end, it was just me. And this person tells me, well, I wish I had the same bravery, the same wherewithal that you have. I don't think what I do is brave. I just don't let any person, place, or thing, including myself, cause me to put me on hold or to defer until my ship comes in or until I get a better job or a job or a paycheck from somewhere. I'm just not going to do that. When I set out to do this show, I didn't know how I was going to pay for the show. I didn't know how I was going to pay for the space, but I did know I wasn't going to charge the artist. I wasn't going to charge admission, and I knew the show would be successful. Originally, I had hoped for 100 people to show up. I would have been so happy if 100 people showed up. It was only supposed to be a 3-day show. It ended up being a month and a half, almost 2 months long. And for the opening night, like I said, I was hoping for 100 people. I had over 400 people come to the event. And they didn't just come to the event and walk back out. They came to the event and they stayed. And I think the reason, actually, I know the reason is because I prayed about it, I believed in it, and I worked towards it. And I didn't worry about where the money is going to come from. I didn't worry about any of that. All I cared about was doing this show, hanging out with some of my friends who are artists and photographers like myself, and raise some awareness. Well, the person says, I wish you would have waited so we could have done the show together. And I looked at him and I said, just like you shouldn't be spending your energy watching videos, ignorant videos from people who just want to spew negativity, I am not going to wait on somebody to do something. Because I just looked at him and I told him, I said, if I waited for you, I would still be waiting. Don't make excuses, because that's what they are. I'm going to wait till my ship comes in. Oh, I got to wait till I get my income tax check. Oh, I'm going to wait till next week. My ship came in December 19th, 1968, 46 motherfucking years ago, and it's been sailing from sea to shining sea, shore to shore. It's been in some battles. It's been in some storms. It almost sunk like the Titanic, but baby, it is still sailing because I refuse to give up. I refuse to put me on hold, whether I'm battling cancer or HIV or the 29 months of homelessness I went through, whether I'm battling being poor and broke right now. My ship is going to sail, and it's going to be a grand voyage no matter what. I will not defer anything in my life until my ship comes in. My ship is already here. My life is already happening, so I won't let anything, especially money, convince me that I can't create, that I can't do great things. It's just not possible. My faith won't let me believe that way. So I just wanted to say, one, don't let ignorant people cause you to react to something. Don't put you off or what you want to do off until tomorrow. Tomorrow is not promise. All you have is this second, right here and right now. Live for now, live for today, tomorrow, next week, next year. None of that is promised. And before you know it, you'll be 50 years old with your same plans that you had when you were 21, waiting for your ship to come in. That's all I wanted to say. Don't let other people tell you who you are. Don't let other people dictate or cause you to react to their ignorance, to their stupidity. And don't, definitely do not defer your happiness, your peace, your joy, your contentment. You can do all things, and the only person, place, or thing that will prevent you from doing it is you. Peace and blessings, everybody. That's all the time I have. Bye-bye.